this word bless your life.
Na neno hili litabariki maisha yako.
And may this word bring a total transformation in your life.
Na neno hili litaleta mabadiliko kamilifu katika maisha yako.
I'm so overwhelmed.
Nimejawa sana
by this word.
Na neno hili.
And I pray God.
Na ninamuomba Mungu.
That you receive it spiritually.
Kwamba utalipokea katika hali ya kiroho.
And you get the revelation.
Na upate huo ufunuo.
Behind this great truth.
Ulioko nyuma ya kweli hii kuu.
It is a big revelation in my heart.
Ni ufunuo mkubwa sana katika moyo wangu.
For me, it's as if this is the answer to our 40 days prayer.
Kwangu mimi ni kana kwamba hili ndilo jibu la maombi yetu ya siku 40.
It is such a light in my spirit.
Ni nuru ya ajabu katika roho yangu.
And I pray that it will bless you.
Na ni maombi yangu ya kuwa haya yatakubariki wewe.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hebu tumtepee Yesu.
Let us wave unto Jesus.
You know, sometimes the word may come as a seed.
Najua mara nyingine neno linaweza kuja kama mbegu.
We get pregnant of the word.
Tunapata ujauzito wa neno.
But it's not every time.
Lakini sio kila wakati.
That we bear fruit from that word.
Kwamba tuzaa matunda kutoka kwenye hilo neno.
There are some spiritual miscarriages.
Kuna kuaga na kupotezwa kwa mimba au mimba hutoka ya kiroho.
And I pray that God will protect this seed.
Na mimi naomba ya kuwa Mungu atailinda mbegu hii.
That will be pregnant of this seed.
Kwamba utakuwa mjamzito wa mbegu hii.
And we will see forth fruit from this word.
Na tutaona matunda kutoka katika neno hili.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Today's message.
Jumbe wa leo.
Is still about mentorship and spiritual covering.
Bado ni kuhusu kuwa chini ya uangalizi pamoja na ufuniko au kifuniko cha kiroho.
We had a good time with women.
Tulikuwa na wakati mzuri na
wanawake. There is a powerful message that came.
Na kuna ujumbe wenye nguvu uliokuja.
A powerful revelation.
Ufunuo wenye nguvu.
About what Dorcas was doing for widows.
Kuhusiana na kile ambacho Dorcas alikuwa akifanya kwa wajane.
Though it is not written in the Bible.
Ingawa haikuandikwa kwenye Biblia.
But if you learn about Dorcas.
Na mpaka utajifunza kuhusu Dorcas.
You find out that she was a widow.
Utagundua ya kwamba na yeye alikuwa ni mjane.
So she knew a lot about being a widow.
Kwa hiyo alifahamu mambo mengi kuhusiana na hali ya ujane.
And she was still young.
Bado alikuwa kijana.
Being a widow.
Kuwa mjane,
it is losing the covering of your husband.
Ni kupoteza ule ufuniko au ulinzi wa mume wako.
It is not about the money he gives you.
Sio kuhusiana na fedha anazokupa.
It is not about the love he gives you.
Wala sio kuhusu upendo anaokupa.
But it is about everything that he is for you.
Lakini kuhusu kila kitu mumeo alivyo kwako.
These days,
siku hizi,
if your husband is not rich,
kama mume wako sio tajiri,
women of the world,
wanawake wa ulimwengu,
they tend to disrespect their husband,
huwa wanawadharau waume zao,
because he is not giving enough provision,
kwa sababu hatoi fedha ya kutosha.
But being a husband,
lakini kuwa mume,
is not only about provision,
sio tu kuhusu kuweza kukutana na mahitaji yaliyopo.
Though a man shall provide for the family,
hiyo ingawa mwanamume anapaswa kukutana na mahitaji ya familia,
I don't see your husband as a provider only.
Lakini usimtazame mumeo kama tu ni mtu wa kuweza kukutana na mahitaji yoyote.
Like in Kiswahili there is a joke that says that women have become like goalkeepers in their houses.
Kama kwenye Kiswahili kuna huu usemi wa utani unasema kwamba wanawake wamekuwa kama magolkipa nyumbani mwao.
Yaani wanategeshea baraka tu, wanategeshea baraka tu, wamekuwa kama goalkeepa.
They just position themselves for blessing so they become like goalkeepers in the football game.
My husband, your husband,
mume wangu, mume wako,
is not only a provider.
Sio tu ndiye anayetoa mahitaji.
Because God is the first provider.
Mungu ndiye anayetupa mahitaji ya kwanza.
God does not bless.
Kama Mungu hatabariki.
Even your husband will not be able to meet your expectations.
Basi hata mumeo hataweza kukutana na matarajio yako.
But God has set your husband over your life.
Lakini Mungu amemweka mumeo juu ya maisha yako.
To be a covering.
Ili awe kufuniko.
To be a covering.
Aweze kukufunika.
By who he is.
Jinsi alivyo.
And by what he has.
Na kile alicho.
for covering.
Bas men ndio anakufunika.
He's the covering over the wife.
Yeye ndio anamfunika mke.
He's the covering over the children.
Anawafunika watoto.
So when you are a widow,
wewe unapokuwa mjane,
you lose the covering.
Unapoteza ule ufuniko.
The society can despise you.
Jamii inaweza kukudharau.
All the men that could not even approach you when you were married. All the men.
Wanaume wote samahani.
That could not approach you when you were married.
Wanaume wote ambao hawakuweza kukufuata wakati ukiwa na ndoa.
They start coming closer.
Wanaanza kukusogelea.
They start showing you that they can do something for your life.
Wanaanza kukuonyesha kwamba wanaweza kufanya kitu kwa ajili ya maisha yako.
That is for interest.
Lakini ni kwa ajili ya nia fulani.
That's why you find that many widows. They fall into a snare.
Who are wanaanguka katika mtego
of being prostitutes,
wakuwa malaya,
hidden prostitutes,
ambao ni wa kujificha.
But in reality, it is not because they are behind bad manners.
Sio kwa sababu wanaizo tabia.
But it is because somehow. They are still looking for that
covering.
For the society despised you.
Kwa hiyo jamii inakudharau.
And in-laws despised you.
Na hata wake wanakudharau.
Saying maybe you are a curse because of you that their son died.
Wakisema pengine wewe ni laana kwa sababu yako bwana wao alifariki.
Even the children may not respect you because there's something missing.
Hata yawezekana watoto wasikuheshimu kwa sababu kuna jambo linalokosekana.
That's why we see that single mothers, they are going through a lot.
Na ndio maana tunaona wamama ambao hawana waume wanapitia mambo mengi.
Because men have that eye that if they look at children, children respect.
Kwa sababu wanaume wana ile jicho kwamba wanapotazama watoto, watoto wanaheshimu.
But the mother alone.
Lakini mama peke yake.
You find that it's hard.
Unakuta ni ngumu.
To take that position of a man and the woman in the house.
Kuchukua hiyo nafasi ya mwanamume na mwanamke katika nyumba.
So because Dorcas went through all that.
Kwa sababu Dorcas alipitia yote hayo.
Spiritual nakedness.
Ule uchi wa kiroho.
That cause.
Ile baridi.
That lack of finance,
ule kukosa fedha.
That lack of favor,
ule kukosa upendeleo.
That spirit of death fighting,
ule roho ya mauti ikipambana.
Because remember,
sababu kumbuka,
a man and his wife,
mwanamume na mwanamke,
they are one.
Ni kitu kimoja.
When the enemy takes away your husband,
yule akimchukua mmeo,
that spirit will be hovering over that family.
Ile roho itakuwa ikiendelea kuwa juu ya ile familia.
Because there is a strong tie between a wife and the husband.
Kwa sababu kuna mfungamano wa nafsi kati ya mume na mke.
For a widow will always be thinking of dying because she saw how the husband died. Oh. That experience is still in her mind.
Mjane itakuwa mara zote akifikiria kuhusu kufa kwa sababu aliona jinsi mume alivyoondoka, kwa hiyo lile wazo bado linakaa katika mioyo yao.
I decree and declare,
ninatangaza,
that we shall not be widows before age,
kwamba hatutakuwa wajane kabla ya umri wetu.
And I decree and declare,
ninatangaza na kuweka wazo,
that we shall not die prematurely,
tutakufa vifo kabla ya wakati wake.
Because two are better than one.
Sababu wawili ni bora kuliko mmoja.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Kuwa katika jina la Yesu.
And those who are single,
wale ambao hawana wenzi,
I decree and declare,
natangaza na kuweka bayana,
that you receive a partner who will be a covering for you.
Kwamba utampokea mwenzi ambaye atakuwa ndio kifuniko juu yako.
Because it is not in the will of God for a man to live alone.
Maana haiko katika mapenzi ya Mungu kwa mtu kuishi peke yake.
It is not even in the will of God for a woman to stay alone.
Na wala haiko katika mapenzi ya Mungu kwa mwanamke kubaki peke yake.
Hallelujah.
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 So Dorcas understood all those things.
Wale ndio kasi ya leo hii yetu.
And that's why in her,
ndio maana ndani yake,
through the Spirit of God,
kupitia roho wa Mungu,
he started taking over.
Akaanza sasa kuchukua nafasi.
And cover all the widows of the city.
Na kuwafunika wajane wote.
And I was telling ladies,
na nilikuwa nikiwaambia wa mama,
you know, when we think about Dorcas,
tunapofikiri kuhusu Dorcas,
we imagine that she was collecting clothes like we do today.
Tunafikiri pengine alikuwa akikusanya nguo kama tunavyofanya leo. All the
clothes that you don't wear anymore. Nguo
ambazo huzivai tena.
All the clothes from your neighbors.
Nguo kutoka kwa majirani.
Then you go and give it to widows and to poor people.
Tunakwenda kuwapa wajane na watu maskini.
This is not what I'm talking about.
Kitu ambacho nakizungumzia.
I'm talking about covering the nakedness of someone.
Ninaongea kuhusu kufunika uchi wa mtu fulani.
Either spiritually,
ile ni kiroho,
either financially, we together? He became
a Japanese.
Someone who covers.
Who covers?
He covers
a Japanese.
The same.
Maybe.
And those meetings.
The one or the
And that's where the topic came. That when you are called, when you are in the apostolic ministry, God gives you a mantle, not only a garment, hallelujah, that garment that you should be able to extend your garment to your sons and daughters to cover their nakedness in one way or another.
Hallelujah.
I spoke about a man. The name is Noah.
I find Noah.
He was drunk one day. And all the clothes were taken out. And one of the child came. He saw the nakedness of his father. And he ran. As if it was funny. Come and see. How our father is naked. But those two ones, when they came, they understood that the father was naked. They could not look at the nakedness of their father. They went. And they covered the father. If it is not for the blood of Jesus, we are all naked. If it is not for the grace of God, though you may have hundreds and hundreds of outfits. In the eye of God,
it's
so naked. The works of the saints, those are the garments and the clothes. And the Bible says he was full of good deeds. So we are continuing with the spiritual covering so that we may understand how you may be naked while it is your right to be covered. Are we together? The Father was the covering of Jesus Christ, the Son.
Baba alikuwa ndiye anayemfunika mwanawe Yesu Kristo.
The Father and the Son,
Baba na Mwana,
they were one.
Walikuwa ni kitu kimoja.
Because of that covering,
kwa sababu ya ule ufuniko.
Until Jesus said,
Baba Yesu alikusema,
if you see me,
ukiniona mimi,
you see my Father,
ukimwona Baba yangu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you see me, you see my Father. Because he was in the Father. And the Father was his covering.
He
does extend that when you see one, you see the other one. That's the restoration that God wants to restore in the church, in the body of Christ. In our families. That we are one language. Not in distractions. Like Ananias and
Sapphira.
They were one.
But
in distraction.
But
I pray that the husband and the wife will be one in the glory of God. In restoring. And I pray that we will be one in this church. In the will of God. That we will be one in this vision. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So as we are covered as your leader, so you will be covered. So that if God sees you, and see the sister and the brother,
waona viongozi,
it seems like one.
Wanatuona kama kitu kimoja.
Is it possible?
Inawezekana.
Is it possible?
Inawezekana.
When we go out,
tunapotoka,
when people see so and so from this town,
watu wakimwona huyu na yule kutoka katika
kanisani,
wanajua
this is the child of Zion,
kwamba huyu ni mwana wa Zion,
this is the daughter of Zion,
ni binti wa Zion.
This man looks like someone in Zion.
Anaonekana kama mtu fulani pale Zion.
Though we carry the different blood,
and God deals with Adam to fight,
but we are all covered by this vision. I see God is bringing our hearts together. And that's why I told you, this message for me is like an answer to all these prayers we have made. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't hear your amen. And I pray that we get it spiritually. Sometimes you release the word and you realize that the person is taking it
physically.
And when you receive a spiritual word physically, it brings problems. May you receive it in the spirit. Hallelujah.
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 So today we are going to read about the fatherhood, about mentorship, and the spiritual covering.
Leo tutakwenda kujifunza na kusoma kuhusu mtu anayemuongoza mwingine na kuhusu kifuniko cha kiroho.
And we are going to see this great prophecy that is coming.
Na tutakwenda kuona huu nabii mkubwa ambao unakuja.
Those who are in the spirit, they will get it.
Wale walio katika roho wataupata.
And I pray that it cannot be so for you.
Nami naomba ya kwamba haitakuwa hivyo kwako.
That that word will be fulfilled.
Na kwamba neno hilo litatimia.
The word that says that they will hear but they will not understand.
Ile neno ambayo inasema watasikia lakini
I pray that you hear and you understand. In the name of Jesus. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 6.
We
will base our teachings on that. But we will be reading some verses. Malachi 1.
Kusoma Malaki sura ile ya kwanza,
Malachi 4,
mstari wa sita na Malaki 4 pia.
Let's read in 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 6.
Kusoma Wafalme wa Kwanza wa pili sura ile ya sita mstari wa kwanza mpaka wa sita. Naomba utanifuata kwa Biblia ya kwako. Kisha wana wa manabii wakamwambia Elisha, angalia basi mahali tutaapo mbele yako ni padogo kwetu, basi twende mpaka Yordani tutakuomba kwa huko kila mtu mmoja ili tujifanyie huko mahali pa kukaa. Akajibu, haya nendeni. Mmoja wao akasema, uwe radhi basi na kusii uende pamoja na watumishi wako. Akajibu, nitakwenda. Basi akaenda pamoja nao. Nao walipofika Yordani wakakata miti, lakini mmoja wapo alipokuwa katika kukata boriti, chuma cha soko kikaangukia majini. Akalia akasema, ole wangu bwana wangu, kwani kiliazimwa kile. Mtu wa Mungu akasema, kiliangukia wapi? Akamwonyesha mahali, akakata kijiti, akakitupa pale pale, chuma kikaelea. Baba, naiitia damu ya Yesu juu yetu sisi. Vunja roho ya usumbufu. Ninavunja roho ya kutokuamini. Ninavunja roho ya kukosa ufahamu.
I pray that those who hear my voice,
ninaomba ya kuwa wale watakaoisikia sauti yangu,
I pray that they receive this word as a light,
ninaomba ya kuwa watalipokea neno hili kama nuru,
that will direct their spiritual life,
na kwamba itaongoza maisha yao ya kiroho,
and affect it in their physical life,
na kugusa hata maisha yao ya kimwili.
I plead the blood of Jesus,
naitia damu ya Yesu,
and I break the resistance in this place,
na ninavunja upinzani mahali hapa.
Spirit of judgment,
roho wa hukumu,
I break it in the name of Jesus.
Ninavunja katika jina la Yesu.
Spirit of sadness,
roho ya uchovu,
I break you in the name of Jesus.
Ninavunja katika jina la Yesu.
I pray Father,
naomba Baba,
that we see a spiritual breakthrough in this place,
kwamba tutaona uponyo wa kiroho mahali hapa,
through this word,
kupitia neno hili,
and let your will be done,
na acha mapenzi yako yafanyike,
in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu.
Let's all say amen.
Na sote tuseme amina.
This message is divided into two.
Ujumbe huu umegawanyika mara mbili.
From verse 1.
Kuanzia mstari wa kwanza.
To verse 3.
Mpaka mstari wa tatu.
The Bible talks about the sons of Elisha.
Biblia inaongea kuhusu wana wa Elia. Wa Elisha.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The sons of the prophet.
Wana wa nabii.
And I want to see. I want you to see and realize the relationship that was between these sons and the prophet. Hallelujah. Before we talk about the sons, let's go back to the level of Elisha and Elijah. Because Elisha was assigned to Elijah. And let's see what he received from Elijah. The journey of going Elijah and Elisha together. Hallelujah.
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 And you just see that what we read here is just exactly what Elisha received from Elijah. It's only what you have that you can pass to your children.
Hallelujah.
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 The sons are telling Elisha, this place we are sitting in, it is becoming small. This place is becoming small. Why can't we go? Go up
further
and find a big place for us. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is a sign of maturity. When a son gives an advice to the father, and the advice is valuable. When a son starts seeing big, seeing big is a sign of maturity. When you are a child, you just want to grab everything. But you are like a chicken. You are just holding small things. You cry because of small things. But when you are growing, you start seeing a big picture. I always tell my children, in life, I have realized that you have to fix the big picture and despise details because you can dwell in details and lose the big picture. But if you want to move forward, your eyes should focus on the big picture and then you despise small, small things. Then you shall go far. But if you are still grabbing and holding small things, they will be too heavy for you. Even in marriage, I'm talking to husbands in this place. And I'm talking to wives in this place. If you want your marriage to last longer, you have to understand that there are small, small things that you not like. But you have to know the big picture of your marriage, the big picture of your family. Then you focus on the big picture and
all
those small, small things before the sun comes down. Make sure those small, small things have been wiped away. Your marriage will last long. But if you are angry more than 1 year because of something, small, small arrows, people start seeing your face with black, black areas here.
Wow. Watu wataanza kuona uso wako ukiwa na makunyanzi.
Because you cannot sleep anymore.
Sababu huwezi kulala tena.
Because of those small, small things.
Sababu ya hayo mambo madogo.
But women,
lakini wanawake.
This is the time we should stay.
Huu ndio wakati wa kupaswa kusema.
In this marriage to stay.
Niko hapa kukaa.
I am here to stay.
Hatoki mtu hapa.
I am here to stay.
Sitoki.
Because the big picture of my wedding.
Sababu picha kubwa ya ndoa yangu.
Is that God hates divorce.
Kwa Mungu anachukia talaka.
God hates divorce.
Mungu anachukia talaka.
I'm here to stay.
Atoki mtu hapa.
But if your husband is at work,
lakini kama mmewe yuko kazini,
and you start saying,
alafu unaanza kusema,
if I go,
nikienda,
maybe I should take this shoes.
Labda nichukue viatu hivi.
Maybe I should take this handbag.
Labda nichukue mfuko huu.
Maybe I should take this and that.
Labda hiki na kile.
Where's the checkbook?
Hebu ikitoka
kidogo. No, I'm divided.
Yani akili yako imegawanyika.
One day if I go,
siku moja nikienda,
let me start putting my money aside.
Ngoja nianze kutunza fedha yangu kabisa.
You will be shocked.
Utashangaa.
Of course you will go.
Sawa, utakwenda. Lakini uko pale kubaki.
Hallelujah.
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 Because we are moving towards perfection.
Kwa sababu tunaelekea katika ukamilifu.
No one is perfect.
Hakuna aliye mkamilifu.
We are together.
Tuko pamoja.
So that together.
Tukutane kwa pamoja.
We may see. We may go from glory to glory.
Tuweze kupanda na kwenda utukufu hata utukufu.
When your wife will have white hair,
Captain Kerr, the Kapukua, and you will see a buzzing
thing. The wrinkles everywhere. Then when you go for a party, you are not proud of her anymore. I see
this face.
Even those who are born again, they are going for a party. What is sitting there? And the husband is sitting there. And when they go back home, 10 meters between them.
Yani kuna kona mita kumi
kati yao.
No.
When she was young,
alipokuwa kijana,
we used to admire her.
Ulikuwa unamzimia kweli.
But now she has given birth to children.
Lakini sasa kapata watoto.
The body has changed.
Mwili umechoka.
Now you feel shy.
Sasa unajisikia aibu.
Mungu atakushangaa.
God will be amazed at you.
We are still going where we are going.
How is known as my friend.
So, Elisha, was a man who could perceive greatness, even more than the father. Do you believe that? Because as they were going together, Elisha could see the manifestations of Elijah. Because of that mantle he was carrying. Because of the anointing he was carrying. And he was following him. Many people remained behind. But Elisha was following
him.
But guess what? Elisha. Believe that he could receive in two portions. He believed that he could receive double portions of his father. I told you, if you are not spiritual, you won't receive
it. He
perceived that he could receive double portion of his father. Even when Elijah said, what you are asking, it is difficult. It is difficult. But if it happens, for you to see when I'm taking, if it happens,
if you go there,
if you can see, then the spirit of greatness will be upon you. If you can see in the spirit, but if you cannot see, you just desire greatness. You just speak of double portion. You have to see in the spirit.
So katika ulimwengu wa roho.
Lazima
utamani kupata vazi la upako la baba yako.
You see?
Naona.
You wait for it.
Unalisubiria.
You want it.
Na unalitaka.
Then,
alafu,
you'll be able to receive.
Utaweza kupokea.
Double portion.
Upako mara mbili.
Hallelujah.
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 Who is this father that will not want greater things for his son?
Who is the baba wa nagani ambaye asingependa mambo makuu kwa ajili ya mwanawe?
I like Jesus.
Mimi nampenda Yesu.
He's not like those people that when they see that you are coming up, they start pushing you down.
Yesu sio kama wale watu ambao wakiona unaanza kuinuka wanakukandamiza chini.
But Jesus said,
lakini Yesu alisema,
the things I'm doing,
mambo ninayoyafanya,
you will also do them.
Mimi pia nitayafanya.
Even more.
Lakini makubwa
zaidi. It is the spirit of fatherhood.
Hata roho ya ubaba.
The things I'm doing,
mambo ninayofanya,
you will do it even more.
Fanya hata zaidi.
In the name of
Jesus.
In the name of
Jesus.
But there's some requirement.
Lakini kuna vitu vinahitajika.
So Elisha.
Kwa Elisha.
Was a man that could see great things.
Alikuwa mtu ambaye angeweza kuona mambo makuu.
And that spirit,
na ile roho,
was coming down.
Ikawa inashuka.
To his sons.
Kwa mwanawe, kwa wanawe.
That spirit of greatness,
kwa ile wa ukuu,
was coming down. To his sons. Let me say it again. That spirit of greatness of Elisha was coming down to his sons. And see the statement they say. Father, this place is becoming small. This place is becoming small. Because they could see the spirit of greatness over the Father. And they started breathing the same spirit. The spirit of increasing. The spirit of seeing greatness. The spirit of expanding. It did not come just from nowhere. It came from the Father. Who received the portion of Elisha, Elijah. Now that anointing was coming down to the
Father.
I do believe. When they told him, Father,
Baba,
this place is becoming small. I can perceive. The big smile he had when they said that. He said, indeed it is small. Indeed it is small. It did not end them. Not only they saw increase. But they have been mapping the place.
To know where
they can find a bigger place.
Na kujua wapi watapata eneo kubwa.
To know where they can increase and expand.
Na kujua wapi wanaweza kuongezeka na kutanuka.
To know where there is abundant life.
Kujua wapi kuna maisha tele.
Can you make a spiritual mapping?
Unaweza ukafanya kutafuta ramani au kupanga ramani
yako
kwa ulimwengu wa kiroho.
And know clearly how you shall expand your family.
Na kujua wazi kabisa jinsi ambapo utaweza kutanua familia yako.
And know how you shall expand your activity.
Na kujua jinsi ambapo utatanua shughuli zako.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's not everywhere that you'll be able to expand.
Sio kila mahali ambapo utaweza kutanuka.
But it's according to the direction of God.
Lakini kufuatana na maelekezo ya Mungu.
They took the right place.
Wakachukua mahali sahihi.
Near Jordan.
Karibu na mto Jordan.
Near Jordan.
Karibu na mto Jordan.
Near Jordan.
Karibu na mto Jordan.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You will always increase.
Maana zote utaongezeka.
When the rivers
of the Mito
of the living water are inspiring your
decisions.
When you have the rhema word,
that
will direct you, even in your business. That rhema word is your
children.
So you will not go far from what God said. You just go closer. You just go closer. I don't know about you.
Me,
I have discovered. The more I go closer to this business, the more I'm prospering. The more what God did over me, the more I go closer to that place, the more I see clear. The more I see increase.
The more I see increase. spoken from the
His word God spoke. He
breathed.
It is your blessing. Don't you understand
that?
If you are a son, unless you see
this
vision raising in your life, you will not be able to see it. Don't go far from Jordan. Don't go far from this vision. Don't go far from what God said over this vision. It is our blessing. It is our blessing. When we seek the kingdom of God first,
then
all the blessings shall follow. Why? Because we are like that tree planted near the river. That tree that is planted near the water. We shall prosper and we shall have fruit out of season. All seasons,
we
shall bear fruit. We shall bear fruit. Don't go far from
Jordan.
Tell your neighbor, don't go far from
Jordan.
Because even when there is no rain, when you live closer to Jordan,
you shall not be
there. Whether there is rain or not, when you are closer to
Jordan,
I tell you, you shall increase. There is the spirit of greatness in this
vision.
Whether people like it or not, whether they give us names, it does not matter. God has released that spirit over us. We don't have the choice. We cannot change it. It's part of us. It's like those people who are changing this year. You are born a woman and now you want to become a man.
It's like those people who go for operation to change their sex.
Or you are a man, you want to become a woman. You are wasting your time. Before you realize, cancer will take you in the corner. How can you imagine? A man with beard, with a big voice, and he is putting, I don't know, breast or force. I don't know, plastic, I don't know. It can never be the same. Even that woman, even when he's touching that breast,
he
just know that it's different. Because what is fake is fake. Even when you pretend it is fake, but what is from God? Oh my goodness. Visions are fake. From internet, cut and paste,
cut and paste.
Like you are putting iron bread. But what has been
given
by God? Oh my God. Even though you go through valleys, even in the darkest hour, even when you are hungry, you will still be grateful. Say, though I am hungry, but I know I will be able to feed thousands of people. Even though I am in the wilderness, I am able to feed 5,000 people. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. The spirit of greatness that was over Elisha was coming down
with
the sons
from
the
Quran.
He said, let's go closer to Jordan. And he said, yes. Go. It is in the will of God. And I want to tell you, it is in the will of God for you to
prosper.
It is in the will of God for you
to increase.
Because it is in the will of God
to
have a greater place, to have a greater land. On the 31st, I'm going to announce people.
You
want to build this coming year.
Hallelujah.
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 By the Spirit of God. God.
Wa roho wa Mungu.
They shall drink
water jenga.
Hallelujah.
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 You may say I have already a house.
Sasa sasa mimi nyumba tayari.
It's okay. You leave it to your children.
Watu watoto wewe.
But increase is your portion.
Lakini Mungu yetu ni sehemu.
Hallelujah.
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 You can go. The journey of increase.
Hiyo ni safari ya mwongezeko.
One of them.
Mmoja wao.
If we go without him,
tusipokwenda na huyu bwana,
no covering for what we are doing.
Hatuna kifuniko kwa kile tunachokifanya.
Moses told God,
I
don't go with you.
Come,
I will not go.